as they're coming in to line up. I'm going to go ahead and kind of start. I want to welcome everybody and thank you for coming. We're pretty excited to have everybody back. It's nice to be able to do something in person again, and I hope you guys are able to enjoy that as well. I'd also like to thank the members tonight that are representing all the branches that will be with our color guard, and I would like to thank those that have served in the past and are serving now as well. A couple of announcements. There are going to be a link on the school's webpage with tonight's performance and the slideshow that goes along with it. I think she said we received well over 100 pictures of people that are represented in the service that have family members up here on the stage. Also, when we exit, if you have a student that is in Miss Bourne's or Miss Jacobson's class, you will be going out to your left. So Miss Bourne's and Miss Jacobson's class, the students will line up out there, and then when you guys release, you'll be able to grab your child from that hallway. If you have a student in Linton, Matheson, or Jordan, did I say Jordan before? That was Bourne and Jacobson. Over here is Linton, Matheson, and Jordan's class. So you'll be exiting to your right if you have a student in those classes, and they'll be lined up on that hall out there, and you can grab your student as you're going out that way. So as soon as they get in here, without further ado, we'll be able to enjoy the performance they've been working.
Welcome to our fourth grade concert, America the Beautiful.
We would like to extend a special welcome to all the servicemen and women in the audience.
Please stand and join us our national anthem.
Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may now be seated.
Thank you.
It has been a really tough time with It has been a very tough 2 years with COVID. We all hope it continues to get better and never happens again.
We all now know how important it is for us to work and care for one another.
And this time has reminded us of the many people who are willing to sacrifice for our communities.
Mrs. Runland, is it possible to make the monitors a little bit louder?
Brother, when you need a hand,
we all need somebody to lean on.
I just might have a problem that you'd understand.
We all need somebody to lean on. When you're not strong, then I'll be your friend. I'll help you.
Thank you to the police officers, firefighters, healthcare workers, and other first responders.
We would like to thank our teachers who found ways to teach us online. They didn't have time to figure out how this was going to work. They figured it out as they went along.
Thank you to all the moms, dads, and grandparents who watched us while the other adults had to go to work.
Thanks to our school cafeteria workers. Did you know they made hundreds of weekly lunch boxes so all kids could continue to receive healthy meals during quarantine? They needed the cafeteria, gym, and kitchen to organize all that food.
The Civil War marked a terrible time in American history.
Southern states fought against northern states.
Some families were even divided against themselves, and brothers fought on opposing sides.
The most dangerous battle of the Civil War was fought at Gettysburg. Afterward, President Abraham Lincoln went to Gettysburg to give a speech reminding us of the importance of reuniting our country.
This next song, Battle Hymn for Gettysburg, combines the popular Civil War song, Battle Hymn of the Republic, and Lincoln's Gettysburg Address.
107 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men were created equal.
Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation or any nation so conceived and so dedicated can long endure.
We are met on the great battlefield of that war.
Come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live.
It is altogether that proper that we should do this.
But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here have consecrated it, far above our poor power to add or detract. It is for us to be dedicated to the great outpouring. It is rather us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave their last full measure of devotion.
From the earth.
In 1900, James Weldon Johnson wrote a poem to express the hope and the future that was born out of the dark past of slavery.
James' brother, Rosemond, composed music for this poem.
Its first performance was during a celebration of the anniversary of President Abraham Lincoln's birthday in the 1900s.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the
song.
live in a country where we are guaranteed equal rights. This civil rights song reminds us that all are welcome to sit at the table of freedom.
Patriotism means to show the love for your country. Enjoy these wonderful patriotic songs.
Beautiful horse, nature's crest, forever brave. sister cities gleam, haunted by human tears.
America, America, God shed his grace on thee.
And
around heaven with brother from sea to shore.
I'd like to pay some tributes to some very important Americans.
Our military has protected our people in the way of life since the foundation of our nation.
There are five branches of the military: Army, Navy, Marines, Air Force, and Coast Guard.
And don't forget the Space Force.
Yes, it's awesome how much technical advantage we have achieved through what is described as a sister branch of the Air Force.
This next song, the Armed Forces Medley, consists of the official song for each branch of the military.
Unfortunately, the Space Force does not have an anthem yet, so we will acknowledge them now.
Do we have any veterans in the audience? We will honor you by singing Armed Forces Medley.
When we sing your song, please stand.
Haven't even been able to sing yet, but we can't thank these people enough and the whole military that they represent, so thank you. If you could all have a seat. I don't know if you happen to hear Connor, but this is audience participation time. So if you have served in any branches of the military, when we sing your song, if you could please stand, because the students have been so excited to learn about all of the sacrifices you have made, and we want to share this with the audience. We can go ahead and start the music now.
Army!
Could you please stand? We would like to thank you as a whole group.
You may be seated. As you can see, we have some very special guests with us tonight.
We are so honored to have these men and women with us tonight. And the students have made plaques to thank our military representatives, and we really appreciate it. The first one that we have here tonight is Lieutenant Kimberly Monsevais. Your maiden name was a lot easier. I actually had Kim when she was in fourth grade. And now I have her son, David, is with her right here. And so, Kim, thank you so much for your service. I'm so grateful to Notre Dame ROTC and Midshipman Cardenas. Oh, good. It is such a privilege to have someone so young to be serving our country, but also to be serving us with a fourth grade concert. I'm not sure that many people her age would be willing to come here, but we are so, so thankful for representing the Navy for us. Thank you very much. Private First Class Maxwell Van Goey, and I am so thankful to be here. He's with his sister, Sophie, and Maxwell is in the Marine Reserves, and he actually took off the evening of work and drove over an hour to be here, and I'm so grateful for his time. So thank you. And this is my buddy Dave, although I should address you properly, Master Sergeant David Hallgren. His wife Denise teaches here at Edwardsburg at the primary. He has been with us every single year we have done this concert, and I am so thankful for his service and also his being part of our community. So thank you, Dave. All right, so we have one last song to finish up. So if you guys could go ahead and set the flags back up, I appreciate you so much. Thank you. Our service members have graciously been willing to stay after the concert tonight. We have been learning as students to be respectful and so grateful to our military. If you are a veteran and you'd like to have a picture with your child in the with the military flags across the lobby after the concert, you are welcome to do that. Thank you so much for coming tonight.
We can't wait when we get to see our brave men and women come home.
Enjoy this last song by arrangement of Dolly Parton, When Johnny Comes Marching Home, accompanied by Mrs. Schrock and Nora Davis.
comes marching home again. Hoorah, hoorah. Oh, give him a hearty welcome then. Hoorah, hoorah.
The men will cheer, the boys will shout, the ladies, they will all turn out. The joyful day when Johnny comes marching home.
Get ready for the jubilee. Hoorah, hoorah. We'll celebrate the victory. Hoorah, hoorah.
We'll all join in the big parade. He'll let the soldier have his day. The joyful day when Johnny comes marching home.
Thank you so very much, families, for coming. If you could give us, please, just a moment. Students, go ahead and start going out to the hallways. So, yep, if you could go ahead. Parents, if you could give us just a few moments, your children will actually be lining the white hallways coming out here. And so we just want them in place so that as you leave, you can just pick up your children. And again, Mrs. Linton, Miss Matheson, and Miss Jordan's class will be in this hallway, and Miss Jacobson's and Mrs. Bourne's class will be on this hallway. Thank you so, so very much for coming. Have a great evening.